Hello and welcome to my day number 14 hair diary in combination with mood diary. And today we're gonna do this hairstyle called brocade plait half style. So what we need to do is start with dry hair, section out the back of your hair from the top of your crown to the right behind your ears and keep it out the way. Okay, what I'm gonna do is, so this is kind of like a top of my head, so I'm just gonna kind of section it like that. So I'm taking this part here, and then in here I'm doing it in approximately the same place. I can see a problem here. Or maybe not. Yes, I can see a problem here. So the final version of this has to have two plaits long enough to be tied together. But because my hair at the front are a little bit too short, okay, we'll do our best. But what I'm doing now, I'm just kind of getting a bit extra hair. So that we can work with it. And in here, I'm just gonna brush at the top. Okay, and just kind of like clipping, putting tiny clips so that the other hair are not in the way. Okay, make a 3-strand plait on the right. So we use the right side. This is my right. When you have 5 centimeters left, use your left hand to hold one of the strands of your hair downwards. Hold the other two with your right hand vertically. Okay, so I'm now just gonna do simple plait from 3 strands. So I'm kind of like intuitively dividing my hair. I don't know if intuitive is the right word, but kind of, you know, you touch it and you can feel how much hair you have in your hand. And I'm just doing simple plait. So when you have 5 centimeters left, it says, so that's not five, that's not five. Well, it's a different length, this one. Okay. Okay, now it's five. When you have 5 centimeters, 2 inches left, use your left hand to hold one of the strands of the hair downwards. Hold the other two with your right hand vertically. Take the 2 strands you're holding with your right hand, slowly pull them upwards while you hold the third strand in your left hand. As you move the strands up, you will see the bracket pattern form. And after that, you need to hold the ends of the hair tightly and continue plaiting. Then brocade the section again. Okay, so I now pull. Actually, I need to do it like that. So what I'm doing, actually, I'm sectioning it. Actually, I see what's going on here. So as I'm pulling it, it actually becomes this kind of like a little bit distorted pattern. Not following instructions exactly, but I think it's actually supposed to be something like that. Yep, something like that. Yeah, and then continue plaiting. Not much left to plait, but I'll do my best. And done.
And now I
have to do exactly the same with my left hand side. So I'm just gonna do it again, three sections. One, two, three. And just do the plait. I actually don't know if I should do it tightly or loosely, because it looks like if I would do it tightly, then it would not, it would, you know, like it would be holding firmly together and it would not really move up and you wouldn't get this type of pattern. Yeah. Okay. So I'm just keeping this very tiny short little bit there because I know it's going to become longer. And now I'm just gonna pull, this hair up. Yeah. More. Okay, that's a bit too much. Okay, like that. And they say continue plait in a normal plait. So, actually, it looks quite cute. So, I actually just used the clip at the end to clip it. So now let's see. Huh. Basically, I don't know if I can actually even connect those two together. I think I'm gonna have to use these clips to actually secure my hair there. So, and then I'm just gonna decorate it because it doesn't quite connect on the other side. So I'm using one of the clips and I'm taking another from my hair and I'm just clipping this plait on the side as well. Okay, so, and one thing that I actually already prepared for decoration was this awesome thing, which is, it's kind of like this. So I think actually it's gonna be perfect. I'm just gonna show you how it looks from the back and what I'm doing. I'm basically just putting this big thing on the top. And I'm trying to actually, I think I should remove these first because I actually somehow thought that it will hide it. So I'm just actually using this. Okay, and one of the hairs strands came down, so now I'm just gonna clip it underneath the brooch thing and maybe even secure it here. You know, sometimes you just need to have some extra bits to keep your jam going. Okay, so that's the brocade plait. I think it's actually probably better for those who don't have these kind of like different lengths at the front or shorter lengths at the front. And they say after you finish, basically spray it with the high shine liquid. Hair shine liquid. I'm using actually something else. It's absinthian oil. So I'm just basically adding some oil on my face. Okay, and the earrings of today is, I got them in Bali. Probably I have terribly overpaid, but I like them because they look some kind of like a little bit tribal, I say. It has some sort of character. And what about my mood today? I guess right now I feel maybe, you know what, my constant mood score is like a 8 out of 10. Now I say it's like 8 out of 10 again, because no lunch yet. However, I've been doing some ideas. I've been thinking of some ideas about my business and about, you know, the skills I need to develop, and I've been feeling creative. And when I feel creative, I feel awesome. So I think creating anything kind of like puts me in a powerful mood. I was also listening to some podcast on Taurus North Node, which is what I am, what I have. So it's basically your kind of life path direction, and that you need to develop financial stability. And this is something that it has been really learning for me in this lifetime. Also, I feel actually joy because I have reconnected with my mom. Actually, I called her and I spoken to her, and the earrings. And yeah, actually, I felt good after that because I felt like, wow, I talked to my mom, yay! And I wrote a long letter, four small pages, about how I felt when I was a child, and you know, like asking to forgive me about the things, and also kind of like claiming my position as a child and letting go of guilt and responsibility for my mom's life. And then I had like a 10-minute call, and I explained to my mom that I'm going to be sending her a letter and things like that. So it felt really kind of nice, you know. I kind of like put boundaries which I before this I didn't feel like I had with my mom. I felt like my boundary in the last, I don't know, couple of years or something was better, but okay, it was kind of like a boundary of, I didn't feel that triggered anymore, but my contact and my distance with my mom kind of increased. So, but then I kind of like found myself that I actually want to have something, but something that, you know, doesn't interrupt my direction. So I decided, okay, to put the my connection and contact with mom within boundaries. So I said, okay, mom, I have this idea, and we talk every week for 10 minutes. And actually, she was really happy to hear that. So yeah, and I've done it, and I talked to my mom today, and I felt like, yeah, wow, okay, this was nice. And I was able actually also in a conversation, you know, kind of like to say, okay, this is something, for example, I don't want to talk about, and that's something that I want to talk about. So, you know, like, I didn't really feel that. I actually felt positive after this. Like, lots of people, they say they feel exhausted after their conversation with mom or some other person that they have to keep in contact. I think in my case, that was years ago, but then I kind of like emotionally cleared the charge between me and her. But I think I kind of like left it there. I didn't really have come back to the place where I have some regular connection. And now it was the place, like, you know, first of all, you are completely dependent, then you become independent, and then you become interdependent. So kind of like now consciously decided to have a connection with my mom, you know, like interactive connection on a weekly basis. So yeah, that makes me feel good. I'm proud of myself. So I hope that you're having a good day. And what would be my wish for you today is, if there is somebody in your life where you feel that they kind of taking energy from you, I'm not saying they do, but it feels like they do, perhaps it's a good idea to review your boundaries and to see if there is something that you can decide and agree upon. Like, okay, I can see that person that much, but not that much. And, you know, to see if you can get agreement with that, because I think that's a huge improvement. Because sometimes we don't want to cut people off completely. We just want to have this kind of like a control, and we don't want to be overwhelmed with the person. So I think if we put them in the right boundaries, then we can have this effect of enjoying our connection and yet not feeling overpowered by it. So that's my wish for you for today. Thank you for watching, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.